for the Best of the Footy Show.
Is there such a thing as the Best of the Footy Show?
Please welcome the boss, the king, the main man, Paul the Batman Walker.
So, what's doing? This is, of course, the Best of the Footy Show. We've had a great year this year. Really enjoyed bringing the show to you for about 32 weeks. And tonight we're going to look at the highlights and some of the lowlights of the show. And Peter and Blocker, welcome, boys. What's doing? Pete, give me a highlight. Give me something.
Oh, you mean apart from working with you guys,
yes,
Paul?
Yes.
I think the footy. I think what we saw week in, week out, it was a great season, and I really enjoyed that. And tremendous to have so many new faces on the show as well, plenty of the players coming in.
Okay, what about the show?
The show was good fun. I really enjoyed it this year. I think there's a lot of new segments which were really enjoyable, yeah, and probably a little bit more footy this year. I think people probably appreciated that as well, but, mate, I had a good time.
All right, Blocker, what about you, mate?
Just love being here, Paul. just happy, just tagging along after you blokes, picking up the crumbs. Beautiful stuff. All I can say is, dead set, thank God for Mario, because without him, you two deals just give it him every week. Good on you, mother. Beautiful.
Well, I reckon Pete's about to introduce a couple of real standout items.
Well, look, I do think one of the highlights of the show is the fact that over the last couple of years, we've been really lucky to have a lot of acts come on the show, some world premieres, world exclusives, and this year, once again, was no exception. Tell me why.
Something very special. I went along to the Shania Twain concert out here in Sydney about 4 or 5 months ago.
It's not special, Paul. Trust me.
I'd never heard of her because Kim said, "Let's go. We're going to the Shania Twain concert." I said, "We're catching a train where?" You know? No idea. But I ended up standing in the second row and just watching this. What a drop dead gorgeous 37-year-old just killed it. And it's in the end, she threw her phone number at me. And we've kept in contact, so she dropped in this week for something very special just for us. Here she is, Shania Twain. Love you, darling. Hey, look, 60 Seconds has been a regular on this show for about 5 years, but we did one earlier in the year, which is about Crueler for Everyone. Remember this with Jean-Claude Van Damme, one of your best, Pete.
One of his best. Spending 60 Seconds with Sterlo is the muscles from Brussels, and with Hollywood tough guy Jean-Claude Van Damme. Firstly, Jean-Claude, what's the best thing about Hollywood?
Oh.
In your own time.
The best? The question again, please. Go for it.
All right. Second chance. What's the best thing about Hollywood?
Yeah, what's great, you can find out who you don't want to be sometimes.
Yeah, that was worth the wait. I'm not proud of it.
Of my friends.
What's the one thing that you can't do without?
With my friends?
Oh, whatever.
Cannot do without them? You mean they have to be there, not to be there?
Oh, forget about your friends.
Sorry.
What's your worst habit?
I'm very impatient.
The best advice you've ever had?
Just to believe in what you want to do in life, and to say thank you in advance. No, if.
So that's it. That's the good advice.
And that's the best advice I can give them too.
And finally, at last, if you were down to your last $10, what would you spend it on?
Three boxes of oatmeal, Quaker, and a big bucket of like those 2 gallons of water. That will take me for two and a half weeks to live in. I'll make from now to then, like $1,000.
Yeah, couldn't put it any better myself. Thanks for spending the longest 60 seconds with Still Out there.
That's good.
Of course, one of the big hits on Channel 9 this year was Who Wants to Be a Millionaire by Eddie Maguire. Our own Fat did Fat Eddie Quagmire. Have a look at this.
Hello, I'm Eddie Quagmire. Who wants to be a millionaire? Mario Fennick of Lower Redfern, are you ready to play?
Eddie, can I take a 50-50?
No, you can't, you idiot.
Hey, Eddie, just call me Mazza.
Is that locked in? Is that locked? Is it locked up?
You should be locked up, you crazy flea. Just ask me a question.
First question, Muzza. To wipe out your phone sex bill. Who said, I love yous all?
I'll take 50-50, Edster.
Have you got any idea, you idiot?
I've got to use my lifeline. I've got a brain here that's going to help me out. Brother, you got to help me, brother. Help me.
Is that pizza joint? I ordered that pizza an hour ago. What are you doing? I'm starving.
Blocker, it's me. I'm with Eddie Quagmire. You've got to help me, brother.
I'll rack off, Maz. I'm waiting for my stuffed crust.
I've got nothing. I'll go to the audience, Eddie.
Mario's a wanker.
Second thoughts, Ed. I'll brush the audience. I know the answer. It's Fennick.
Are you sure? You sure?
900% positively positive.
Totally locked in?
I'm locked.
All right, Mario. For $1 million, the answer is we'll find out after the break.
That was okay, Eddie. You've done me. Show me the money.
There you go. Eddie Quagmire at his best there, Mario. He'll be coming on the show himself a bit later. Now, look, as per usual this year, we have not made a mistake all year, have we, boys?
Never.
We nailed everything.
Absolutely disgraceful last week.
Great show last week.
Absolutely disgraceful. I think for the first time in the history of television, yeah. The Yanker, the main man...
Right. Yeah, what?
Farted on air. Oh, no.
I don't believe you. I don't remember it.
Okay, make your own mind up. You'll have to listen very carefully to this, but This is what happened last week. I think Parramatta, tremendous value, $2.55 there, except they haven't won that marathon since 1990. Oh,
there was disasters happening in New Guinea with a tidal wave, and we started... What? Well, he's going. No, he's going. There's your camera down there. This one. And it's over here.
Mate, you'll find it. There's only two. You're zeroing in on it.
Let me tell you, it's been a very special week for our little friend Peter Snorkeller Sterling, because his beautiful wife, Selena, gave birth to a baby girl last Tuesday, oh. Hannah Sterling. She weighed £7.12. Yeah. Peter Sterling! Oh, OK, let's just grab the baby now. She's
Mate,
just...
be careful with her. She's only...
She's just 2 days
old. You could have got a new pram, Peter.
She's just absolutely beautiful. Oh, just picking her up now. And here she is.
Have a look at Peter Sterling, some of his stuff last week.
Now, this is our League of Our Own entry for this week. That entry wins this great prize. That's Craig Lowndes, and you can have one of those by coming
Mark
up with
Scaife,
the...
Mark Scaife, mate.
Oh, Mark Scaife, was it? Yeah. That was Mark Scaife there. On...
No, you're on fire, Pete.
I am indeed. If you haven't been to Stadium Australia, that's something on its own. Now, the other thing too... What tape am I throwing to?
Look, we'll take a break. 20 more coming up after the shoot. After this, I'll tell you what. I've got your disease from last week. Normally, I never make mistakes on this show. I mean, you know that.
No, you're going good.
Let's take a break. But as we go to the break, it's our anti-ad. Different this week. Sometimes we always wonder about.
And wonder.
They don't really
and
go,
wonder.
Do they? But what people think about this show, what impression we're giving. We got a drawing from a 7-year-old boy during the week. Let's have a look. There's his thoughts of what he thinks of the footy show. Now, that was after the Oba show. Very good. Very good. 7 years of age, eh?
I'm a little bit worried about his drawing of certain parts of the body.
What do you mean worried?
Seven.
Mate, I've actually commissioned him to do a whole range from a house.
I'd like to know how his mum gets around during the day. You mentioned soccer stars. Some of the great soccer stars of the world. George Best, Pelé, Romario, Diego Maradona. Absolutely sensational. It's a big night tonight. Got some very special guests coming on, of course. 8 weeks to go in the rugby league, and the top eight, we're looking to see who's going to make that, and it's going to condense into... There's about 11 teams can make it, and eight will. There you go. You're not helping. You've got nothing. These are from Ian Wallace of Blacktown. He's 11 years of age, and there's one of me. Very nice. Lovely. A big one, a blocker. And who's this bloke?
Ian. Yes.
Now, speaking of referees, some of the best tossers got together this week. Just have a look what the refs got up to this week. You talk about tossers. Have a look at this. Like, are they kidding or what?
What are they, practising
their... Well, it's practising the toss. Like...
You can do that in private, mate.
Normal people toss in private, don't they, really?
Doing what?
Well, we're supposed to be a team here, aren't we?
Always, you know that.
You've been keeping something from us. Were you separated at birth? Have a look at this photo
that I know
here. Like, look at that.
Hey! We got a couple of more.
It's not.
Drawing set here. Ty Austin from Toowoomba had a go at these two blokes. This is Laurie.
I'm happy with that. I'm happy with that.
Yeah, that's good.
That's after a night out, obviously.
There's the fat.
And there's Fatty, which I think is a distinct likeness.
Very good. Good on you, Ty. Ty's 11 from Toowoomba. And he won't see 12. Good on you.
Yes, some of our best work once again. We did have some weird and wonderful things that did happen on the set this year, and here is just a few of them.
You can see there's only three of us, so we're looking for a fourth panel member. We've got one planned tonight. It's the man that we hate, but we know you want and you love. Here he is. Make him welcome. Bad luck, mate. Big chance for you there, but gone. That's the last we'll see of Mario for 99. How good is that? Now, listen, you know, I'd like to see. I'd like to see you arm wrestle the big fella.
Oh, no. Very good. Very good. America, I'm a gentleman. I would never do that to a woman. I know someone who likes a bit of a roll around on the carpet. Myself, the fat. Why don't you wrestle the fat man?
Yeah, I like the crack.
Some water or something?
What's doing? Just
juice?
Juice. I need some juice, let me tell you. Righto.
Come on, fatty.
Are you going to put your...
Take the scare out,
fatty.
No, I'm not scared. Just give us the 1, 2, 3 block.
1, 2, 3.
Okay, now that's good. Now that was good, but what we're going to do, a special experiment here. Roddy needs to sort of get cut again. He needs to do a few bench presses. So instead of using a weight. Peter.
Now make sure you stay stiff, Pete.
Let me borrow a ring off you now. Now, let me tell you the reason why we're taking this ring off the man, because we're going to suck his ring in the belly. Say goodbye. My man, I have here a lock and a key. Can you please lock that for me now, pull out the key and double check he's locked once you've taken out the key? Yes?
He's locked.
Put the lock in my mouth. Pop it in the key. Now, we're going to put the key in the lock, unlock him, find the ring, put the ring in the lock him, pull out the key, and bring him back to you, son, locked in the lock. Okay? Let's do this one. Okay. Now, I have the key going in the lock. We're just unlocking them now. We have them unlocked. We've got your ring inside, and we're going to lock that. Okay, my man. Here we are. Should have swallowed a football, shouldn't I? Coming up for you now, let me dry him off. He's a wee bit wet. Good? See that in there? There you are, my man. Check that for me. It's not wet, he is dry. Hey, do you want the key? I've got to get the key out. Oh, you know, there's a wee problem here. It's gone too far. I'll bring him back for you. But we're going to have to bring the key back by using a number 5 billiard ball. That is for real. You check that, man. Yeah. Can you imagine swallowing a diamond that size?
No.
I am popular with the Colombians. No, joke. Okay, we're going to suck the ball in the belly. The ball goes down, the key comes up, the ball comes back.
Oh, yeah, that's a great ball.
Nice one. Thank you very much for that. Thank you. Give the man a big hand. Well done.
Now, the beauty of the What's Doing segment, it appeals, it goes across all communities. It appeals to the battler, the middle class, the higher class. It cuts across race, colour or creed, right? It's a segment.
Oh, this is that. Oh.
The trainer cracks the whip and Junior's got a smile. He tells them there's 400s tonight, but they know they'll do miles. Picking up, putting out and trying to beat your time. Siggy picks a move out and says run the right lines.
Down on the corner of Darling Street, the Balmain Tigers are playing. bring a girl, grab a seat.
Got no idea, very apologetic. How did that get a run? We don't know. That's the worst of for the year, for the Bears Head and the boys, the Balmain boys singing that song. Look, we'll take a break now, and after the break, we've got plenty more happening. As we go to the break, here are some of our better indie ads of the year.
Well, the 400 metres, big moment coming up here at the Olympic Stadium for Jessica Nifna from the town of Denver. She had a good run, she's got a fantastic lane draw. She's had a great lead up to Sydney. Two sub 50 times this year. National champion. There'll be so many people wishing her well here today. This is what it's all about. This is the dream.
Walk me through this.
They're off. And oh no, Jessica's taken a tumble. Golden girl from Gallagher, Tommy Copper. Always the Jessica Nifna. What a tragedy. I wonder how they're feeling back home.
Socks. I don't get my socks. I'm out of business.
Did you check all your stocks?
There's no socks in my stocks.
Did you check down at Blocks?
This is Blocks. There's no socks. Get your hands off your
Take it easy, big Blocks. You'll get a twist in your jocks.
I reckon your socks are stuffed down your jocks. That would have given your girlie the shocks.
Don't you start talking. I've seen you in frocks.
Which part of your head would you like me to box?
Which part of your head is not filled with rocks?
While you guys are fighting, I'm still waiting for socks. What is it with men? Must be their
sweet lady, get a box full of socks. Bet you all you can get is a dose of the pox.
I reckon you got the smallest of
You better get busy and change all your locks.
I've still got no box. No box full of socks.
Hey, I got your cocks.
Thing as good as your white cherry with blooming summer roses.
Oh, that catch, I mean, what a catch. It was one of the great days of my life, actually. I was a huge cricket fan growing up during the 60s and 70s, and I got to play with that day some of the greats of that era, Greg Chappell, Dougie Walters, Joel Garner. They were just heroes in my eyes, and just to be on the same field with them was fantastic.
Well, Fatty is going to complain about that. The keeper, the Australian keeper, missing one off his bowling.
I took an earlier catch, Doug Walters smashed one through mid-wicket, and I caught it out in the boundary. No dramas, just a simple, straightforward catch.
Well, there's a little tester for the outfielder. Oh, that's well caught. Well caught by Paul Barton.
And then we were sort of getting in a bit of a rut. And how was I to know that, you know, within 15 seconds I would take probably the greatest catch ever to be seen on a cricket field?
That's in the air. Who's under
underneath that one. This is going to be a catch, is it? No. Oh!
I must have been 70 yards away. I'm sprinting for it, fast as I can. The little legs, the little chubby things, are going, you know, very, very fast. And I'm looking up and I'm thinking, oh, I can't possibly get there. Can't possibly get there. But then as I ran faster and faster, there was a ray of hope. I'm thinking, well, I'm some hope here. I'm going to get this. And I just one last surge, my inner strength came out and I stuck my hand out. And it plopped into my right hand. What really excited me was that both the teams just ran out in the field and surrounded me. And I had blokes like Ian Healy and Greg Chappell and Jeff Thompson going, greatest catch ever. Great, unbelievable. How'd you catch it? Was this the best ever? Joel Garner, oh, great catch, man. All the legends. I've just got to say, you know, it was.
There you go. That was one of the great catches, let me tell you. And look, two great players who retired during the year came on the show plenty of times. They're both superstars. They're heroes of mine and of yours. Please make them welcome Alan Langer and Paul Harrigan. Now, how's retirement treating both of you legends? All right?
Well, it's not too bad for me, but I've got to get the boots back on for
Warrington. Yeah, off to Warrington. Must be pretty excited about that, Alf.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a new challenge and looking forward to it, Fat Man.
And Chief,
just taking it easy,
good?
Mate. Yeah, you know.
Hanging out,
feeling good. Summer's coming.
Beautiful.
Been a great season.
Up to Crescent Head for the...
Crescent Head, I'll be there. You'll be there?
I'll be out there, mate. Riding the Malibus.
Couple of beers.
Now, look, the stars of the show aren't the people who sit here. They're the players who come on the show and they make it for us. Here's some of their best bits. On a personal note, Laurie, exciting news for you. During the off-season, you got married.
Yeah, that's right, got married. Found myself a lovely girl. There she is. I know she'd been home watching.
Yeah, it's a good sort.
Yeah.
You should see the photos here, mate.
Mate, as groins, you don't really know when you've done them. It's not until you after the game you cool down a little bit. Certain groin injuries, you know, when you're done. But yeah, it's not until you cool down in the shower later on. You know.
Yeah, go on.
But your groins.
Go on. So you're in the shower and then
you feel you.
What happened then? Yeah. Now, Jason, just one last question. Reading the papers during the summer, I was quite alarmed to actually read that the headline said Jason Stevens gives up sex. Is that what's doing?
Yeah. That's true.
well, I mean, you had to believe it was in
that?
The
papers. No, that's right. I just, since I've become a committed Christian, you know, it's like, understand why God wants people to wait and, you know, he actually wants to have a fulfilling sex life for his people, you know, he really loves them. And, yeah, so I've made the choice to wait. It's still, like, not a rules thing or regulations thing, but...
Is it hard? Realized, I mean...
Yeah, it does get hard at times.
Who's your favourite player?
Daryl Trendall.
Fantastic. We've got Billy Moore coming out with the North Sydney Packers for you. Here he comes, Billy Moore. Your brother Kerrod's wife was involved in an accident in Singapore. Any news on her?
Yeah, it was in Thailand.
Aren't they next to each other? I mean, something.
Phuket, I think is the name. But yeah, she was actually pretty bad. She fractured her skull and... Broke her arm. She fell off the back of one of the taxi things around the corner and fell on the road. And luckily there was a nurse who was there with her and she resuscitated her. So otherwise it might have been a lot worse. So actually I'm sure she's watching in Phuket, Maureen, so I hope you're feeling better, Dom.
Oh, yeah,
and my grandma, we had a bad weekend too, just while I'm rolling there. My grandmother fell over and fractured her pelvis. So grandma's in hospital in Ipswich, so I hope you're feeling better too, Gran.
How's your cat, your budgie, everything else all right?
Yeah, it's everything... Everything else okay?
I'm having trouble breathing here. I'm between Fatty and Tubby. Like,
you got enough room there, mate?
Not a lot of room, I've got to tell you.
Every now and then you see something on a footy field that you're probably not supposed to see. Now, at halftime last night, the boys came out after halftime. We just got a bit of footage of Kevvy Walters. He's just standing there. Just keep an eye on Kevvy. Oh, what's doing? Here he goes. Watch it. Ruska. Just lets one. Just lets one rip. And Kev got the out of the system and had a big game as well. Good on you, Kevy. Well, you're very lucky. I mean, if you weren't riding a horse, you'd fair dinkum, you'd be an extra in Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Well, let's be fair dinkum. Well, or you'd be a garden gnome or something.
I'm
someone's front yard.
Give me a go, will you? I'm lucky enough to have met Bob Fulton, and I'm mates with him, and Bob said, if you couldn't wash a car or mow a lawn, you'd never be in first grade ever, fatty. So, you are kidding.
What's doing? Just to take us through what's happening here, Craig.
Just greasing me down, I suppose.
Honestly, it could almost make a man turn, but I'm not going to. He's as Penrith as Katoomba, or the Blue Mountains, or all that sort of stuff. He's as Penrith as they come. A big hand for Greg Alexander. All right, now, Denny, first of all, congratulations from all people around the world concerning your falcon, your golden falcon last week. Let's have a look at Denny Bedaris's golden falcon. Here it is right now.
Well, Andrew Johns gets a miraculous pass away. He's almost on the ground here. And Danny Bedaris, it's a falcon, all right. There it is. Yeah, just
falcon of the year, that one. That's a great G-up. I mean, you've got players now falconing themselves just to get on the footy show. And Danny, good on you, mate. Well done.
After 10, 15 minutes, I was all right. Oh, those first 10 minutes. I could never think where I was.
He's not too sure about grand final pressure.
I'd be good to be out there, it'd be pretty nerve-wracking. Big crowd, but I don't know if I can get in.
How did you go on the exams? Any good?
Average.
No, average. Yeah. You haven't changed a bit, Fred.
Can you tell us what this is all about, please?
Mate, there's no excuse for that at all.
What's the story there?
Good job.
There's no excuse for
that. No teddy bear in him.
It's your show.
I got nothing.
It's your show.
Now, look, Wayne, just on your own year, you must be happy.
I can't wait to hear this question.
The brain strain is one of the blue chip segments on the footy show. The players love it. Here's some great footage throughout the year. Check this out.
Which golfer is known as the bear? Jimmy?
Fuzzy Zola.
You've got no idea, have you? What's this footage of the bears in action? Answer the following questions.
Oh, dear.
Which of the six had a sock down their pants? David?
All of them?
That'd be Jason Taylor.
Well, you'd know. I mean, I think a multiple choice on average. A pig's orgasm lasts.
Oh,
I don't know. 2 minutes, 30 minutes, or pigs never have orgasms? I mean, fair dinkum. Who's responsible?
Press this? That.
Yes?
Mate, 30 minutes.
Exactly right. How do you know that, Ryan? Okay, Dipsy, La La, Poe, and Tinky Winky are stars of what?
Ryan got it. The Teletubbies.
Teletubbies, yes. Favourite show?
One of them.
Favourite show for Ryan Goodler. And extra point if you can tell me which Teletubby was rumoured to be gay. Yes?
Dipsy Whipsy.
Which famous movie star of the 50s real name was Doris Mary Ann von Kappelhoff?
Ryan.
Doris Day.
How'd you know that?
I saw it on Fantails.
I heard you on Triple M on the Andrew Denton Breakfast Show one day. You did some opera. Give us your best. Big loud voice.
Figaro, 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 Figaro.
Which of the Brady Bunch sisters was the spunkiest?
Marsha.
Yes.
Well, that's in your opinion.
Yeah.
Oh, that's Cindy. I'll tell you. Have a look at this piece of vision from a recent Newcastle Norse game, and we'll ask you a question after it.
We're under the last 5 minutes in this game. North City doing their best to throw the ball around, and mistakes like that can happen.
Okay, it's a multiple choice question. What was Jamie Goddard looking for in Scott Conley's shorts? Was it his car keys, a missing tab ticket, a contract with the London Broncos, or a punch in the face?
Punch in the face.
No, mate, contract with the London Broncos, apparently. Isaac Hayes is a special guest at this Sunday's Logies. He's known for the 70s hit song. It's a multiple choice. Is it A, I've Been Shafted, B, Shaft, or C, Half a Shaft? Ian.
B, I've Been Shafted.
Please thank these
Daddy,
three.
Yes, can I just say good day to my lovely fiance at home tonight, looking after the kids? I'll see you when I get home, darling.
Not the one that got off the bus in the film.
No. She's shaved since then, Blocker. Can I say good day to my parents at home?
Yeah, sure.
Good day, Frank. Good day, Mark.
Ian.
I'll just say good day.
Well, fat man, you've led the way this year. I play with you, mate, you always led from the front. And on the footy show this year, you just showed what you do. Put your body on the line for the show. So you've done a great job. So here we go.
Curtly Ambrose is the man, and he likes to drop him a bit short. I think this is the test. They're faster. Go faster.
This is Curtly. Remember, he's coming from real high as well. He's not real attractive to look at. He's running in. Don't step away because the ball has a nasty habit of following you, mate.
Does it right, eh?
But, this is you're not showing any confidence, so this is what the quicks would do to you. Oh.
Let's just have a look at a replay of that marvellous shot as he faced up the Curtly Ambrose.
I got plenty of ticket, don't worry about that.
Okay, this could be, if you get this.
Could be a music
This
question.
Could be over. Multiple choice.
Major problems with our Jeopardy this year, and our fearless leader is struggling through these. Although he's handling situations like this extremely well.
Has only performed in one footy show video clip. Was it? Excellent. Just take over a minute, Pete. I've got to go and find someone. Oh yeah, don't worry about that. Where are you?
It's a wrestle off.
Oh, Scott, they're going to build a ring.
Yeah, this is a wonderful segment. We'll be back. Thanks, Steve. Thanks, Mark. I don't know who won. We'll be back after we find out what's going on here.
Oh, mate, how are you?
He's afraid. Mark,
that's a big spider. Great friend of us at the Reptile Park, I know, so here you are, Fatty. Beautiful bird-eating spider. Remember the gig with Ian Roberts? That's the one. That's your real one. That's that one along?
Andrew, if you throw a real one, I'm going to knock you out.
Hang on, well.
And thanks very much, Andrew Denton. I'll be getting you back for all that.
What do you mean you handled it well?
I handled it well. There's no worries.
Hang on. Let's just have a look how you handle it. Were you trying to slap this spider around or what? Just have a look. What do you reckon, Blocker? Have you ever seen one of those fish that end up out of water and they flip around trying to get back in the water?
Very scary, mate. I'm scared of spiders, all right? Not a worry in the world there. Sweet. Love spiders. Now, Chief, we'll see you next year on the Footy Show. Big hand for the Chief.
Lovely.
Well done, mate. Mate, good luck over in Warrington.
Thanks,
Alfie, you'll kill him over there. Big hand for Alfie. Thanks very much, mate. Okay, we'll take a break. You're watching the Best of the Footy Show. Back after this with the Maltese Falcon, Mario Fenwick. Yeah.
Oh, I don't know how to cook at all. Weet-Bix and that. Get a good serve of that, but yeah.
I always think you can't go past some crumpets smothered in peanut butter sauce.
It's canned spaghetti, a couple of eggs, mixed with a bit of cheese. It's the only one I've got.
I cook nothing.
I was really impressed in the cooking department. I'm probably more impressed just by washing up.
I'd have to say barbecue sausages with the Maggi sauce. Because, you know, the sauce is already made, you just add water, so that's one of my favourites.
Well, I can't cook. That's why I got married.
Can't cook great deal, so probably the toast of Sangus would go right.
My mince dish, I love mince. A kilo of mince, herbs and spices, tomato paste, chopped up carrots, the works, onions, on about 8 pieces of toast.
I'm trying to impress someone. I'm capable of steak and veg, so, I mean, if they're not impressed by that, they're not going to be.
Hello? Hello?
One of the greatest Olympic bullshit stories that ever I've heard said was by my idiot mate Ed and me. If I hadn't heard it 100 times before, because Ed's the all-time Olympic bore. He goes on and on about this dickhead called Redmond.
It was the 400 metres, and this guy Redmond, he came round the bend, and his leg just gave way. Redmond's collapsed, and this old mate runs up to him, and someone said, it's his father. It's Redmond's father. And Redmond's father, he started building the shit out of him. Yo, get up, you big heap, you big fancy, you sissy boy, you can't run, get up, you heap. Can you believe it? It was Redmond's father, the father of Redmond, Big Red, the Redmeister, Big Daddy O Redmond. And then the crowd rose as one.
Get up, you guy, baby, get up, you dirty dog.
Such a good story. Stop me if you don't want to hear it again, but it's about this guy Redmond.
Enough with the story.
My name is Karen. How can I help you?
Can you tell me how much money I've got in my account, please?
May I have your name, please, sir?
My name is John McQuinn.
Yeah, John, Jane, whatever you like, big fella. You're coming to cash.
Your account comes to the grand total of $34.85.
Do you want to use some of that, big fella?
Thank you.
You're the biggest.
You're the best. I want you back.
Welcome back. You're watching the Best of the Footy Show for the year 1999. It's always good to see Gilly making a special appearance.
How is that account going, Paul?
Long overdrawn, mate. Long overdrawn. Now, look, two of our favourite people on the show are Terry Hill and Mario Fenwick. Terry couldn't be with us tonight. He's out on holiday. He's away for the time being. But the other bloke's here. Please make him welcome, Mario Fenwick. Welcome, Falcon. How are you, champion?
Big,
all right?
Been a big year for the What's Doing juggernaut. She continues.
Well, has there been a special bit that stood out for you, Muzza?
Oh, mate, I've had a few fun segments. It's been good. Yeah, it was funny, but the best parts for me is when I can give it to you blokes.
Yeah, do you feel as though you've got the support of the crowd behind you?
Definitely. The crowd support me? On the people segment, mate, you blokes are eating too much caviar, mate. I'm down to the battler's level, mate.
All right. Well, I'll tell you what. Let's sit back, relax, and watch the best of Mario and Terry.
Enjoy.
I've had Whitlam and I've had Ran and I've had Hawk and I've had Keating, but I've had nothing like the Falcon.
That's right. This is a man of the people, for the people, with the people, up the people and in the people. This is Mario Fenwick.
I want your vote.
I want to be your member.
You've got to be joking.
I'm serious.
Serious? Let's check it out.
No. Well, I tell you what, I want to be your member. What do I need to do?
You want to be my member?
I want to be your member.
Cost you $5.
I'm Terry Hill, and this is the Hill Report. Hardin police were shocked by amazing scenes this weekend in Sydney as Sydney siders turned out to welcome back the victorious world cricket team. Terry Hill was there.
Make your bowl exceptional. Oh, don't worry about that. The tyre just ran out of me toe.
This bloke's got a shocking reputation. I'm not, no lies, people. This bloke, he's got wrinkles older than his latest girlfriend, this bloke. I'm telling you.
Don't work too hard, your brain might explode.
Yeah. Keanu, straight to you with the question. I mean, why did they call the movie The Mattress?
The Mattress. I don't know why they called it that.
But all that flying around, I mean, it reminded me of years back when you'd done all them Superman movies.
Terry, are you guys making him say that? No, that was when I was older, but I'm younger now. Okay. So and that's someone who I didn't know. But
look, rugby league has had a lot of drug problems lately. But I mean, you know, with drugs in the sport, but obviously not for you. You made a lot of money out of speed a couple of years ago.
Oh, my God. I did on the speed. Yes, speed. Speed is good.
Hey, on a serious note, hey, on Tuesday we had a number of the grand final captains from the 90s. The fat wasn't there. He wasn't invited. That's bad luck. But What's Doing was there. Move that camera away. I'll tell you. I'll jump the counter. What's Doing? That's not funny, mate. It's not funny. This is a joke. Well, I tell you. Well,
on a serious note.
Wouldn't you believe it? I asked some difficult. We had some great captains there, and I've asked all the tough questions to the captains. Just have a look at this.
Amazing scenes in America with a man claiming to be the one and only Steve Blocker Roach giving birth to twins. Unbelievable. Doctors have reported that the man is doing well after miracle birth, although they have expressed concerns for the future of the children.
We know that Pete's wife had a baby. He's been handing out cigars. We know you've got one out there.
Hey, Pete,
so
really?
I sent one out for you, mate.
All right, mate, shove it in your mouth. I must admit, though, I thought you could only fire blanks, Pete, so congratulations,
yes,
mate.
Yes, good on you, mate. Shove it in your mouth. Now, let's fire it up, Mario. Fire it up, mate.
Anyway, in world news, a shock announcement from the US President, Bill Clinton. New tariffs on the Australian lamb. The Hill Report went straight to the source for the comment.
I still can't believe it, Ken.
Unbelievable. Thanks, Bill.
Don't
just finally, what's doing joke of the week? I've got a good one this week.
No, good.
Fatty's had his mental problems, right? He books an appointment with a psychiatrist. He runs into the psychiatrist's office with a pair of hot pants made of glad wrap. The psychiatrist says, Fatty, I can see your nuts. Give me some support.
Hang on. Not finished yet. There's one more little carve.
No, I wasn't told
about
this, mate.
Speaking of the joke of the week, we've got a photo of you playing in the junior days for Marrickville. Muzz, have you had a good time this year?
Well, I've had a great time. Will I be back next year?
You'll be back next year. You've brought a lot of it, mate. You've brought a lot of enjoyment to everyone, mate. Mario Fenny, ladies and gentlemen. Good on you, mate. You're good on very well. We love each other. He's a great bloke and he's very entertaining for the show. We'll take a break. You're watching the best of the footy show. We'll take a break and come back with Brad Fittler after this.
Or when you bump into someone in the street. When you're washing your car?
Cleaning the car, mate. Don't want to do mine after that.
You good? You ever sink a ball by accident?
Oh, nice shot, mate.
I remember when you were a kid and you used to go to the toilet, there used to be like one button you press and then you leave. You know the button's divided in two, half and full flush. So now when you finish in the toilet, you have to think about what you just done. About a half or a full. Hey, Mum, can you come here for a minute? What do you reckon about that one?
Yeah, welcome back. Carl Barron there, a good friend of the show. Got some weird views on life, Carl. But look, our next guest, he's not weird. He's probably the best player in the game today, and he's proved to be a massive hit on the show this year. Please make him welcome, Brad Fittler. Hello, Bradley. How are you, mate? All right?
Good, fat man.
Mate, congratulations on the year off on the field, of course. That last game you played a few weeks ago against St George Illawarra, what a match you had that day.
Well, I think there's one good thing about it. I'm glad I finished a week early. We had a shocker against Canterbury, so...
Yeah, good on you, mate. And injuries, how will you be for next year? Everything be fine?
Yeah, well, they've got the test series coming up soon, so hopefully I'll be right for that.
All right. Now, look, one of the most amazing things we saw all year was the day... Who'd you play again? Cronulla, was it? Or the Roosters? I think it's North Sydney.
We took the cameras
into the dressing room. It was just sensational, sensational viewing. Let's have a look at this.
Back there, dummy half for us, mate. All right, you got to be there. Can't be late. Beautiful night for footy, Rich.
Yep.
Good kick and chase, good kick and chase. Run the ball like yourself. As long as our heads are in the right place, as long as we understand what's going to win this, all right? Just all the little effort areas. Don't want your head into all the fancy stuff, just want you into all the effort areas, that's it. All the effort areas. Plenty of talk. Let's go, boys, on our feet. All together.
It's all attitude, boys. All attitude. Anchor, boys, anchor. All right, let's go for it. Come on, go, boys. Let's go, mate.
Now the attention turns to the players, and a terrific battle it should be tonight. These two clubs level on 10 competition points, so ready for a start in Friday night football. The last tackle would land, and across Fittler. They had numbers on the right-hand side. It's not a great kick. It comes back, fielded by Singh. He's with it 10 metres out. He kicks through. He was tripped, was he? Dropped there by Petheridge.
All right, just give yourself 30 seconds. Just close your eyes, ears. Get that shit out of your heads. Get that first half out of our heads. Got 40 to go. Have a relax. Take some deep breaths. Forget about all that. All right, just while you're there, just have a think to yourself. Am I in the game? Am I doing the things I want to do? How's me talk? How's me half a yard? All the little things. Just give yourself 30 seconds. Get all that out. All right, come back to me. We know they're going to try and pull a rabbit out of their hat. 12 beyond on the scoreboard, that's their game. It's going to be a shit kick, it's going to be a grubber kick, it's going to be a flick pass, it's going to be a throw it on the ground and hope someone scoops it up. They'll go for miracles, but they're quite capable of it because of the speed that they've got. You're playing great football, you're playing great football. Let's not bring it on undone by trying to entertain everybody, all right? And lose sight of the fact that we need these 2 points and we've got to move on. All right, who kicks off? We do? Beautiful. We start the platform straight away. Starting 13, straight back to the field. Let's rip it into these blokes and start again, OK?
Sorry, mate.
Freddie, could you talk to him about those? Just be careful. When we kick downfield, on the first play of the ball, see how all their forwards stand in our defence line? And that's where Petheridge went through. Be very careful. Remind the referee when you go back out.
Right? Let's go, guys.
Ready then for the second half in Friday night football. And it is a 12-point deficit for the North Sydney Bears to start the second 40.
Oh, no! How can he tell from back there? Well, that looks pretty forward, doesn't it? Oh, we'll let him have that one.
And he's with it from the 30-metre line. Time is up here at the stadium. And the Roosters, they've made it 6 straight.
There's a win. Here's us to 12.
Super effort. Geez, I'm really proud of that tonight. That was a great win. You know, and they're no duds either. Terrific effort. But you know what? It's only round 7. We've got to get up and go again tomorrow. Great performance, fellas. Very proud of you.
Wonderful stuff there from deep inside the Roosters camp. And Brad, what was the feedback like from the players after they watched that?
It was good, I think. I think Gus being sort of the old and professional, he comes across really well. And, so many people asked me, you know, what it's like in the dressing rooms, and you know, no one gets the opportunity to go, so they did there, and I think it worked out fine.
It was good, and thanks, of course, once again to the Roosters for that. It was one of the highlights of the year. Some of the other highlights, Face Your Fear segments, of course, that we raised during the year about $270,000 for the oncology research. And Brad, your trip in the MIG was one of those things. It was one of those great things in your life that happened to you. And plenty of other players put their lives on the line to face their fears as well.
Fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay.
Come on, fly with me, we'll float down in the blue.
Fly with me, float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Fly with me, we'll take off in the blue.
What you've really got to do is have a touch of the little fella I've got in here. He's only a baby, he's about 4 years of age, got a lot of growing to do yet. Okay, we'll get him out and maybe you can have a look at him.
Oh.
Okay, here he is. His name's Basil, and Basil is a Burmese fighter. Yeah? Come on, look, okay. I'll lay him across your legs. Here we go. I've got his head. Here we go. Forward, come on. Think of the kids. Come on, forward. I've got his head. On your knees, mate. On your knees. Okay, there we go. Now, he's got about 90 razor sharp teeth. I've got the head, but the head end is not the problem. Okay, he's got a severe case of diarrhea. So just watch it.
Ben, this is Mohan. Don't move suddenly. Are you sure? Ben, pour milk in his mouth like this?
Nah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you'll be fine. Nah, you'll be right. You do it.
Here, come here. Take your hand here. Just pour it. Keep pouring like that. Keep pouring. Oh, pour it up. Just hold it. He's going to try to bite it. Good boy, Mom. Good boy, Mom. He's going to jump up. Hey, easy.
We got here a bird-eating spider from far north Queensland. Now, it's a pretty big one. She's about 20 years old or so, something like that. There is no known anti-venom. Nobody knows what the effect of a bite would be on a human being, so guess what? We're not going to use that one. What if it bites him? What's going to happen? Oh! 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 No! We had enough?
It's doing laps.
You had enough, Ian? I think that's worth $10,000.
Yeah!
There we go. Well done.
Thank you.
Now, Well done, mate. Our very own Top Gun there, Brad. Fantastic day. You've already talked to us about it. Would you do it again?
I'd love to. That was it's a really good experience. It's not so scary just flying. It's just when he's going upside down and doing all the turns and that. But yeah, it is a really good experience and worth trying.
Lots of face your fears there. Is there anything there that you saw you wouldn't do?
Yeah, the spiders and anything alive I don't trust.
Yeah, spiders. Spiders aren't my go either. Please thank Brad Fittler. It's been a great year for Brad. He's really come of age on the show. Well done, Brad. Brad Fittler there. Okay, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll take a break and come back with more of the Best of the Footy Show. See you soon.
Wake up and make a mental note not to nag my husband.
I'd explore my private areas.
Come on, lesbian.
Go to the hairdressers. Sheila's always spent a lot of time in the hairdressers.
If I was a woman for a day, I'd probably get a sex change.
Oh, I think if I was a woman for a day, I'd set about breaking down the barriers that have seen men become second-class citizens in this neo-feminist matriarchal society.
Funny, you heard about four blokes,
haven't you? Can we check things out? See what's going on.
Well, I'd sit back about midday and watch all the soaps, and then I'd go and blow all the money that I had in my savings account.
Come to training naked and say, here I am, boys.
So, have an orgasm.
Like all the other girls in the world, just get the hooters done.
Nag everyone.
I'd go around telling all my girlfriends how good in bed Travis Norton was.
What's going on, boys? Boys are back.
Hi, Biff.
What do you think, Block?
Sensational. I'd like to know what your highlight of the year was, Paul. You asked us.
My highlight will be in about 20 minutes when we say goodbye, Rock. I think it's been a long year. It's been a very exciting year, Pete.
I was just thinking of what I would do if I was a woman for a day. I don't think it would make any difference what sex I was. I'd play golf, I'd gamble, I'd just do all the same things. Wouldn't make
exactly
a difference.
Exactly, you would too. Now look, one of our favourite segments of the year, it ended a lot of careers actually before they even started, was No Talent Time. Let's have a look at the worst, or is it the best, of No Talent Time.
Here we go! 1, 2, 3, 4!
I love myself, I really do. No one else love more than myself. 1, 2, 3, 4!
Pronunciation and also exclamation marks, unfortunately apostrophe, perhaps should have been just full stop. It was shit.
Well, you've heard of Wally Lewis, Eva Malmeninga, but you are the best you'll ever win.
And I gave him three, one for the shirt, one for clapping out of time to his own song, and one for showing us what Sturlo's nose is going to be like in a few years' time.
I found it on my finger.
I plucked it from my nose. And when nobody's looking, I wipe it on my clothes.
Scientists are trying to make idiots and they're going to use these kids' brains. Snorky, he should know because the same scientist interviewed him.
Okay, act two is Gabby Darjani and she performs something. Sorry. And he performs.
Good evening and welcome to today's big match between the Parramatta Eels and the Manly Sea Eagles. Parramatta, for their team, the big player to watch out for is Peter Stirling. His big nose can do any damage to any side.
Stirling.
Oh, outstanding.
Gabby, I wanted to give you points for ability, but there was none. I wanted to give you points for humour, but that was lacking. I wanted to give you points for some aesthetic quality, but you're an ugly man. Oh. I give you this score because it's people like you that allows me to work in this job. I give you a score.
It's Jackie the Balloon Lady. Jackie.
First of all, I don't have a tiger pattern to do, but I had a puddle named Tiger, so I'm going to do a puddle. I'll explain more in a... Oops!
That's good so far.
Because we are Barbie girls in a Barbie world. Life is plastic. It's fantastic.
Way down to Georgia, he was looking for a soul to steal. He said a buy, he was way behind, he was willing to make some deals. When he came across this young man, I saw him play, he's too hot. He jumped up on that hickory stump and said, boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know, boy, but I'm a field player too. And you carry a ticket there, I'll make a bet with you. You play pretty good field, boy, but give the devil his due. Cause I bet I'm feeling gold against your soul to say I'm better than you.
Thank you. Now, outstanding act.
I gave him four, and that was for the amount of 50-cent pieces you can put through his teeth in the front.
Best we can do for you all year. The boys are all here. We've got the Chief, Alf, Blocky, Snorky and the Muzzer. Well, boys, good year.
Great year.
Thanks, great, enjoy it.
Fantastic.
Fantastic. All back next year.
I hope so, Fat.
Peter, you back next year?
I've got to say, for the best off show, it was longer than I thought it was going to be. So that's good. Apparently, for more reports, Alan Langer starting the same kind of show in England next year, so we'll be tuned into that.
Hey. Oh,
he'll be the fat man.
And you're going to have a hair transplant.
No, you just keep using it.
And you're going to have a brain transplant. Oh. We welcome you back next year. Listen, thank you for your support throughout the year. We couldn't do it without you. Those letters that come in, all the support we get from the public, that's what makes the Footy Show. Thanks for watching for the whole year. Now, look, if you go to bed normally early throughout the show, you'll have missed this. This is some of the audience members taking us with the Nevilles. And, of course, thanks to the Nevilles for the year. That's it for the show. We'll see you next year. Bye.